You're next in line for the official Holiday World podcast.
Welcome to Holiday World in Splash and Safari.
Dropping in from Santa Claus, Indiana.
Riders will experience swift acceleration, high-speed turns, and sudden stops.
With park president and CEO, Matt Eckert.
Other things randomly drop off on my calendar, but this never does.
Vice president and COO, Matt Bloomhart.
Geese are like the worst.
Media relations manager,
Sabrina Jones.
Oh boy, hot take.
Director of entertainment and events and fourth generation owner,
Lauren Crosby.
I do what I can. It's a podcast.
And director of communications and fourth generation owner,
Leah Cook Bloomhart.
I do a terrible job as a podcast host. Someone should fire me.
Now stow your loose articles, buckle up,
and please keep your hands and legs inside the car at all times.
And we're back. Welcome back to season 5 of the official Holiday World podcast. This is season 5, episode 15, the one with Gravy Boat, Declassified. Today is Thursday, July 13th for us, but we plan to release this August 14th. So if you recall, and if you decided to stick it out with us, episode 13 was our episode with our director of projects and planning, Andrew, where we dubbed out all of the important stuff about good gravy. I'm sorry. I hope you stuck it out. So today, we're just going ahead and assuming that everyone is still busy and recording this on the same day, and we're going to release this episode on August 14th. So without any further ado, here is the unedited interview. All right. Welcome back to the podcast, Andrew, our director of projects and planning. You excited to be here?
I am.
I know this is not why you took this job. But thank you for spending a little time with us. So first of all, I want to start with an adaptation of our icebreaker question, which is if you could have added something to the park for 2024, what would it be and why?
A Vekoma Family Boomerang steel coaster.
Oh, what a great answer. Oh, I'm so happy you said that. All right. So I've been thinking back to the origin of how the family coaster first began. So tell us about IAPA of, was it 2021?
Yes, it was IAPA 2021.
That was your first IAPA,
that
correct?
Was my first IAPA. We met with Vekoma. A couple of us didn't make it. There wasn't the whole group, I don't think.
Were I think you it was just you, me, and Matt B.
Okay, yeah. I think that, I feel like a few more met, but yeah, so we met with them. I don't remember the family boomerang coaster from IAPA. I remember a bunch of really intimidating coasters, and my head was spinning. So
Matt B kicked things off asking about the biggest and baddest coasters.
Yes, yep. That sounds about like Matt
B. And they threw this into the proposal.
Yeah. So what I remember is actually Ricardo from Vekoma wanted to come out. And I'm not going to lie, there was a little bit of a like, okay, we'll sit through that 2 hours and then move on. So about a half hour, that was in May of 22. Mm-hmm. So about a half hour into that meeting, it was very clear that things were going to be changing because they showed the family boomerang on a site in Poland, I believe it was. It was very similar to ours. And it was like, whoa, we gotta do this. And then it was...
The rest is history.
Yes, it was. Or yes, it is.
All right. So tell us a little bit more about Good Gravy. We can finally say it. Is it forever going to be Project Gravy Boat to you?
It will always be Gravy Boat for me.
Just like the dorm Compass Commons is Project Dozer.
The stickers we will make, I hope, will be a little bit of good gravy, but it's definitely going to have the Gravy Boat sticker on it for our hard hats.
Yeah.
It's been Gravy Boat for over 2 years, so it's going to be hard to change. But.
And it's not that big of a change from the project.
No, yeah. It's a little easier than Compass Commons.
Yes.
Yeah, it's a little more in the same. They're in the same.
I got to peel back the curtain on that one. We decided on the project name. Andrew, of course, gets the project name assigned by marketing. But we kind of landed on that because we were like, who's going to actually think we're building a gravy boat?
Yeah. Yep.
So tell us a little bit more about the specific Vekoma Family Boomerang that we're getting.
Yeah, so we're getting the Vekoma Family Boomerang. It is more dynamic than I would venture to say any family boomerang out there. So it's got the Holiday World touch. Mm-hmm. The lift portion of the ride and the station portion of the ride, the Vekoma station portion of the ride, are all off the shelf. They are... you know, the standard. Mm-hmm. Once you leave the station, it is all custom. So we've added some really cool dynamic elements outside of the station to enhance the ride experience. Some of those being the giant cranberry can as you leave the station and bank off to the what we call the photo garden. Adds a nice feature to the ride. So then you go out through some near miss elements of some giant sculptures.
I was going to say, do you want to clarify the photo garden is kind of the giant sculptures seen in the drawings by now, hopefully.
Yes. What we've been calling the photo garden internally is, it has the giant sculptures, but it's an area where folks can sit that aren't maybe riding the ride, or maybe they're doing a parent swap, or maybe they're children are trying to work up the courage to go ride the ride. So within that area, we have a play structure over plenty of seating, shade, fans. We really tried to make it a nice, enjoyable area for moms and dads and children, grandma and grandpa to sit while others might be riding the ride or whatever the situation is. So for the ride, it ends in a dead end spike out in the at the end of the circuit that is 65 feet tall. Questioning whether that's the high part of the ride is 75 feet tall. So, and then riders will go backwards through the circuit of the ride and through this and end in the station where they began.
And of course, the most important thing to us when we were looking for a new coaster, new attraction, share with us the height limit.
38-inch height requirement.
We're so excited for that.
Yes, very important for the whole family to ride.
Yeah.
It has a max speed of 37 miles an hour. We hope to do over 700 people per hour, which that's the theoretical capacity, but that'll add good capacity for the Thanksgiving section.
So, absolutely.
Total length of track is almost 1,400 linear feet. So you travel it twice, so it's really more in the 2,000 linear feet. So it's going to be a good add, I think, for the park.
And tell us a little bit more. So we've talked a little bit about we're going to have a kids' play area. Mm-hmm. Tell us about what went into the planning of that, because you were very key into figuring out what exactly that was going to look like.
Yeah, so that evolved. At one time, we had creatures of Thanksgiving, I think, and the fall. So play elements that kids could climb on and jump on that were soft. But we had a pumpkin, an apple, a bucket of apples, maybe a deer. And that was really cool, but where we landed was a more family-oriented play structure where family guardians can sit around and enjoy the...
accommodate more people at once.
Yes, yeah, more people at once, and also added the comfort areas for parents to sit and watch. So, it took a little bit of planning to get that area worked out.
But I also want to talk about the fact that we went through how many different designs for bathrooms and concrete layouts.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. So we started in, we got our first one in October. I remember, I think the collective response across the design group was, wow, this is really good. This is really close. And I have not counted, but we're well over 10, probably 15 iterations of that.
I would guess.
Maybe more universal that they would know. But so it definitely, we took our time fine-tuning the small details. I think that's that's what took the most time was the details. Trying to add capacity, trying to add efficiencies for folks that are here spending their day. And it can be the best experience possible.
And it's even little things like Lauren requested stroller parking.
Yes. The stroller parking is very, very cool. So last night I was in the park as a guest with my two kids with a stroller. Stroller parking is important. I never knew that until last night. So yes, I think that's a good add. We have a good wide midways that will be accommodating for large groups or all the wagons and strollers. And because with a smaller height requirement, you're going to have a little more of that.
Yep. So tell me, what's it like to work with vendors on things like giant stuffing boxes and whisks, as well as to straight-faced tell a roller coaster manufacturer you want a train to look like a giant gravy boat.
It is different. The vendors are not, they're used to that. So the giant whisk, it's like, oh yeah, that's what we do. What's funny is you're talking to the concrete contractor or the plumber, and he says, what is a rolling pin? I'm like, well, you know what a rolling pin is, but you have to explain it. And then they look at you a little bit like you're crazy.
I feel like we get to dream this all up in like a room on our own, and then you have to go communicate it with the world.
Yeah.
And with serious people like plumbers and people who pour concrete, like, why do I need the path this big?
Yes, yes. there's definitely some strange looks. There's a lot of, you're kidding, right? That's probably the biggest question I get. You're not serious. But back to Vekoma, so when we started the gravy boat project name, we started going down the road of the gravy boat theming. They had not seen our renderings. Mm-hmm. So late in the project, early this spring, I sent them over to Ricardo, and he called me and he's like, hey, is this real? I'm like, yes. And he said, this is wow. And he just kept saying, wow. And he mentioned that his jaw was on the floor because they're not used to our level of theming and
dedication.
Yes. Yes. Dedicated to that. To the very end.
Well, I'm so excited for this project. Let's talk a little bit before I let you go about the theming of the actual station, because that's a huge part of where our money is going in this project.
Oh, yeah.
So to refresh our guest memories, just in case you haven't checked out every single resource we have on Good Gravy now, when you go through the station, you'll be going through Grandma's house on Thanksgiving Day. And of course, as you approach the line, Grandpa is going to realize that we're out of gravy and we're going to need to get gravy going. So that's when you board the coaster. But in order to create Grandma's house, I created a story and gave you a year. And you and our design company kind of did the rest.
Yeah. Well, the story was definitely the foundation that was needed. I read it and I'm like, whoa. And I think the design company read it and it was perfect. They took off with it. And
I don't know. They did such a great job. I mean,
they did.
I gave them 1965 and I mean, everything they found in that design could not have been found before 1965.
Yeah. Well, we spent a lot of time specking. They spent a lot of time specking, receptacle covers, doorknobs, I mean, just the small details of it has to be 1965. Well, the tile in the bathroom was a modern tile, but they were going for the look of 1965. Nope, we had to go with something that was they didn't want to debate whether it was that era or not. And I think they did a good job.
They did such a nice job.
We have shag carpet, so you know that's definitely that era. So that's exciting. But
and the most exciting part of the entire queue, of course, is the fact that it's now going to be enclosed
and air conditioned.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. And the vast majority of the queue line, the waiting time will be in a conditioned space. Mm-hmm. So. And I think that's something we hear a lot of.
One more spot where you can be comfortable.
Yes, yes.
I feel like that's the theme of this whole area that's going in, is going to be comfort for our guests, no matter if you're riding or if you're sitting and watching and waiting for your family to come out. Well, thank you for joining us, Andrew. We'll let you get back because we're still out from announcement day, so you got some work to do.
We do have some work to do. Thank you.
Thank you. Congratulations. You've built your way to the end of another episode. We hope you enjoyed this, and if you listened through the last one, thanks again. Please send all of your pleasant thoughts to podcast@holidayworld.com or reach out to us on social media using the hashtag HoWoPo.
You've been listening to the official Holiday World Podcast.
Welcome back. Did you enjoy your flight?
A production of Holiday World and Splash and Safari in Santa Claus, Indiana. Check out the latest episodes at holidayworld.com/podcast. Thanks for taking a ride with us.
And please come back to see us again soon.
At Holiday World and Splash and Safari, along with our amazing rides and friendly service, there's always free parking, free soft drinks, and free sunscreen. You want the most family fun for your dollar. And at Holiday World, we get you. We're just not out to get you. Get tickets at holidayworld.com.